Yo, what's happening, Fable Squad? I'm coming at you with another NF track from his new album, The Search. This time we're going to do Nate. I'm not even going to go into anything else, guys. Let's get straight into this. You guys know the story. Subscribe, share, drop a comment, drop a like, bloody blah. You know the story. Let's get into it.
Yeah, sometimes I want to disappear like I just don't exist. I find a time machine to take me back when I was six.
What did I tell you about Hans Zimmer, man? That is a Hans Zimmer composition, man. Then he throws a beat and starts rapping.
Maybe younger, either way, I guess the point of it would be to tell that little kid that he's gonna take a lot of hits.
Oh.
Yeah, I'll probably grab your hand and tell you life is hard. If you got questions or you need advice, then talk to God, cause he's the only one that listens, even when you think he isn't. Even good people are great at making bad decisions.
Oh, even good people are great at making bad decisions. That is so damn true, man. It doesn't mean because you make a bad decision, it doesn't mean because you make mistakes that you're a bad person. Good people make bad decisions. Good people make mistakes, man. And that's why I said even before in my last videos, man, you guys need to learn. People need to learn. Not you guys. Everybody needs to learn to drop their rightness. And understand that humans are humans, man. We can make mistakes. Let's go.
Don't take it serious. You find out pretty quick that life is more than just appearances. I know some things we could avoid to save embarrassment, but everything that breaks you down can also build your character. Cause people love to see you fail. Just be aware of it. Don't let nobody tell you who to be or write your narrative.
It's funny. That's what I said in my last video, man. Also, some people love to see other people fail, man. Like, they get a kick out of other people's misgivings. Like, they get a kick out of other people's misfortunes, you know. And I found that a lot with, like, even the MGK videos, man. And even though you guys know I'm the biggest Eminem fan, man, but I like MGK as well, but I don't understand, if you're an Eminem fan, like, why would you wish bad on another artist if you're an Eminem fan? Like, yeah, but I love Eminem, so, you know, I wish bad on him, you know. And one reactor I was actually watching, he was actually watching a diss to MGK. And this reactor said, like, I'm going to watch every single diss until this man's career is over. And I'm thinking to myself, why? How does that bring joy to your life, watching somebody else's career get trampled or stepping on somebody else's grave? I don't get it. Anyway.
Look, we're all products of the things that we experience, but there's a big difference between confidence and arrogance. You hearing this? I know that you don't get it now, but you gon' get it later. I know you feel like you're alone and no one loves you, maybe. And you gon' cover insecurities with lots of anger. The weird thing is someday all of this will make you famous. You start to write about your life, and while they're all relating, you'll make up a slogan called...
He's actually saying the weird thing is all these things that he's talking about actually make you famous, man. That's how twisted this world is today. That actually all these things that are negative, like the anxiety and the being depressed and being alone, man, that at the end of the day makes you famous. Man, NF is forever spitting just real talk, man.
Real, but feel like you're the fakest. Wish I could tell you that your future's nothing but amazing. That's just not the case, and I guess I just don't know how to say this. I don't know if you can hear me or not, but if you can, I just want you to know, you gon' make a lot of mistakes, and they gon' laugh in our face. That's part of life, that's just the way that it goes. That's just the way that it goes. And I don't know if you can hear me or not, but if you can, I just need you to get it. I know you've been questioning life, trust me, I know what it's like. I'm here for you if you need someone to listen. Do you need...
Oh my God. I don't know if you can hear me or not. We can hear you, man. We can hear you, man, because you're speaking real talk, man. We're speaking real talk, man. You are saying exactly what I'd like to say. But however, this is one of... this is taking, like, talking to yourself to a whole different level, right? This is a conversation with himself, all right? This is a conversation with himself, but it relates to us as well. but he's actually talking to himself.
See, mom and dad are not together, they took different routes. But you probably already knew, you're getting older now. Remember back when mom picked us up from grandma's house, and she hid her boyfriend in the trunk and drove a couple miles down the street, and then she pulled over to let him out, cause she didn't want dad to know she had these type of dudes around. Cause last time he found out, he had to take us from her. You look uncomfortable, I'm sorry, let me change the subject. You know how we've always struggled with abandonment? Yeah. And when we feel like so-
This album's all about his life, man. I mean, it's very aptly named, I mean, The Search, but I mean, this album, I found every single song, it's either he's talking to the people in his head, or he's talking about his life, or I see there's a song of his called I Hate Myself. I haven't even gotten to that one yet. And I mean, I would have listened to everything by now, but I don't want to kill my first impressions or my first reactions, so I'm not listening to them until I actually react to them. But this album seems like it's all about like his search, like he's not in a good place at the moment, and he's just trying to work through things.
He's leaving, we start panicking. Yeah, I wish that I could say I've learned to manage it. You think it's bad now, but you don't know the half of it. Passion is something we have never lacked. We see it the most when we're writing raps. They think it's funny now, let them laugh. I know you think it's just an outlet when you're really mad, but you don't know the platform you're about to have. I know some things about the future you ain't ready for. I know some things that you gon' cover up but can't ignore. And what hurts is they gon' surface at the worst moment.
Oh my God. Isn't that so true, man? It always surfaces. It always, your skeletons in your closet, man, will always surface at the worst moment. When you actually don't need that in your life right now, that is when it decides to come out, man. But you know what? That's what builds you as a stronger character, man. That's what makes you stronger. That's what makes you a better to deal, or better equipped to deal with this earth, man. Nothing will ever get thrown at you that you can't handle. Ever. But that's so true, though.
And we gon' act like it don't hurt us, but it hurts, don't it? We walk around with the devil talking on both shoulders. Wish I could tell you that he disappears when we get older. But that's just not the case, and I know you feel out of place. And everything is not okay, and life can be a lot to take. But I don't know if you can hear me.
You walk around with the devil on both shoulders. I'd love to say that goes away but over time, but it doesn't.
Nah, but if you can, I just want you to know, you gon' make a lot of mistakes, and they gon' laugh in our face. That's part of life, that's just the way that it goes. That's just the way that it goes. And I don't know if you can hear me or not, but if you can, I just need you to get it. I know you've been questioning life, trust me, I know what it's like. I'm here for you if you need someone to listen. If you need someone to listen. You know how intoxicated people make us nervous, to the point sometimes we shake and it feels so disturbing. Don't be scared, that's just trauma trying to reach the surface.
Oh my God, that's just trauma trying to reach the surface, man. Ay. I can't for this NF. I can't for this Oak, man.
And tell us everyone we love is gonna try to hurt us, which isn't true, but it's a lie that both of us believe in. Yeah, you might get a glimpse of happiness from your achievements, but what you'll learn as you get older, every time you reach one, is you'll just make another goal that doesn't lead to freedom.
You'll just make another goal that doesn't lead to freedom. Because that's what people do, man. People are consistently chasing these goals, but the goals are monetary, man. They're monetary. I want a new car, I want a new house, I want a new this, I want a new that. But that doesn't lead to freedom. That doesn't lead to happiness. No one ever sets a goal of like, where do you want to be in the next 5 years? I want to be happy. I want to be happy. I want to have my family around me. I want to have people. But people don't say that. People want to be like, no, I want to be in this position. I want to be, I want to have this job. I want to have this promotion. I want this car. I want this, that. So you're always setting goals for yourself. Right? But every time you reach it, you're getting further away from freedom. Man! Dude, what is your... Fuck! What is wrong with this guy? Oh, God, there's nothing wrong with him. What's right with him?
That you can't imagine. At 24, you drop an album and you call it Mansion. At 25, you put out therapy and gain some traction. Skip the track number 4, now that's a really sad one. Yeah, perception's coming next, we about to reach the masses. It sounds awesome at the same time, it doesn't matter. At 27, we'll make millions, but it's really sad, cause you learn to realize that none of this will make you happy.
What did I just say? So he's just listed his accomplishments. He's just listed. He got this at 24. He dropped an album. Then he did Mansion. Then he did this. Then he did that. And then he became a millionaire. But what you don't realize is none of this made him happy. But he's talking to himself, man. The crazy thing is that he's having this conversation with himself. But I actually feel as if he's talking to me, as if I'm in this position.
I could look at you with empathy. Sometimes I feel like I've become what you were scared to be, which makes it really hard to look at you with sympathy. Cause if I'm feeling bad for you, then I have to feel bad for me.
And that's talking to himself. I love that. Cause if I have to feel bad for you, it means I have to feel bad for me, because he's talking to himself. He's talking to his younger self, his six-year-old self.
I feel like we don't deserve. That's why I'm always looking down on you. I know it hurts.
Oh.
A lot of questions I've been trying to search to find us both some answers. I'll be here for you if things get worse.
Oh. Oh my God. This is a different level of talking to each other, of talking to himself. Oh my God. Have you ever had a conversation with yourself this deep? This deep? I'm pretty sure, actually, I have quite deep conversations with myself. I do. I'm very, very critical of myself. So I'll sit often in my head. I'm a very psychological person. And I'll sit in my head and analyze every single thing that I do and every single thing that happens in my life. I'm consistently analyzing. The one thing I'm good at doing is brushing off. So I've got pretty broad shoulders. I can actually brush off the negative side, man. And I can always wake up in the next morning and start to see the sunshine. You know, I always say to myself, the sun will shine the next morning. And I deal with that way, but I'm forever living in my head, to the point that it's in my dreams that I'm talking to myself. It's madness. That's why NF talks to me so much, man. He is such a sick artist, but I'm gonna stop rambling on now because you guys know how I feel. There's more NF coming, guys. Stay tuned, man. Oak is epic, epic, epic. That was NF Nate. Absolutely epic. I loved it. You let me know down below what you think. Comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. To my family, thank you for the support. Thank you for everything, guys. I love you so much. And you guys, just keep with it. I'm going to keep bringing you special stuff, man. I got so much planned for you, man. We've got months of amazing stuff coming. So, yeah, guys. I'm out for today. I'm clogged again. I've got the flu again. I can never shake this damn thing off. Peace.